Okay, Jack.
Double. Happy birthday. All right. Is that your birthday present? How old are you, Papa? How old are you?
79.
79. And counting. Anything you want to tell your great grandkids?
Yeah, I hope I'm going to be a thousand. So I can be with it.
There you go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Papa. Happy birthday to you.
One of the more gratifying things in the field as an ironworker was just to look over your shoulder as you leave that job and know that you were part of something, something concrete, something that'll be there for a long, long time. Quite interesting, you know, when in later years you drive by a bridge or a building that you worked on, is you get this sense of pride. The general public often don't even realize the impact of ironworkers in this country. Whether it's the amusement park that you visit for entertainment, whether it's the bridge that links your community across water, the schools where your children learn, the stadiums where you go to watch your favorite team. Ironworkers have their hand in all parts of construction that affect your community.
Thank you. making the grave.
What do you mean, Nidicha?
See this patch here and see that patch out yonder? It's coming this way and it's going that way, but it's taking a long time to reach it.
I know it.
I, as far as I could throw it by the tail.
Lord, ain't
what
you
is
so,
that?
Lord, have mercy me.
See what it is?
Shower head?
Oh. Hook it onto your hose pipe. All you gotta do is stand up there and do it.
Walk right on down.
And then you water your plants with
on
it.
On top of that whirly bird up there, it done rotted out.
It took it down and set it back there.
And it just tore them roofs off of every one of them houses. Had to go back and do them all over again. Of course, we got about $300 to a house back in the 50s. Lubbock, Texas. That's out in the western part. They had a big ammonia plant there where they I couldn't cut that ammonia, man. That stuff. Oh, Lord. So I pulled up and left. And then I went back to Wooden Abilene, because that's where I was living then. Sweetwater, Texas. That's where they have the rattlesnake roundup every year.
Okay.
And they get some whoop-whoppers out of there. And I went to work in this where they was making sheetrock. And I never thought nothing about it, but that sheetrock has got, it's got asbestos in it. They put it in the firewalls and stuff in the elevators. And They had three big furnaces down in the bottom floor, and they were putting, lining them boilers with fire brick. Great big old big fire brick. And I was mixing the mud for them. To put that,
right.
It was powder, and you just put it in with the mortar, the concrete mortar, and that when you'd open the bag, it just puff and blow. I think that's where I got the biggest part of my asbestos. And then I stayed on for that. The whole thing, and this, they had a hole cut in the floor on the second floor, and two or three guys had one of, they're supposed to have a cable around that hole. There were two or three guys fell off in there, stepped off in there, not knowing where they were going, and killed them. Boy, they had a lawsuit there. OSHA got in on it.
You worked in Texas. That was after you come out of the service?
Yeah. I had a 1935 Ford. So I lent it to my brother. And he went over to Vernon, Texas to a big nightclub dance or something. And he got over there and he lost the keys for the car. And then he decided to hotwire. So he hotwired it. And the cops got him and locked my car and him both up. And I didn't know where he was at. So I finally found him and went to get my car. And battery was run down on it. Where he left the thing wired up and didn't undo it when they pulled him out of the car. He had a 47 Hudson. Yeah, 47 Hudson. Good looking little old car. Didn't have no. He drove it from Los Angeles to Abilene, Texas. And we all hung out down at the where the truckers come in and go out, they had a little office down there. That was my brother.
What was his name?
Harold Turner.
How many brothers you got?
I just had that one brother, and okay. I got three half-brothers.
Okay, right. So he was your full brother, okay.
Mm-hmm. The only full brother I had. And he died with uremic poisoning. And
seeing Laura again at the...
He painted 3 years on that Golden Gate Bridge out there in Los Angeles.
They had to go up to Atlanta.